Hello, I'm Robert Brock, and welcome to the latest KDAB News Flash, the first of KDAB's new news format not tied to a monthly schedule. In this episode, Qt 6.8 release and announcements. Qt 6.8 is a major new release that adds a number of new features and improvements. Let's take a look at just some of the highlights. New modules, introduction of the SVG to QML tool, which can be used to convert, as the name suggests, SVG files to QML, which can be useful for creating user interfaces that use SVG graphics. Qt Quick Vector Image module was added, which allows the direct rendering of vector images without the need of pre-rasterization through hardware acceleration. New features. CMYK support has been added in the Qt GUI module. 32-bit image format support in QImage format, CMYK color space in QColor space, as well as CMYK support in QPDF Writer. Promoted modules. Several modules that were previously in Tech Preview have been promoted to out of Tech Preview status. The modules include Qt Graphs, Qt HTTP Server, Qt Protobuf, and Qt gRPC. This means that these modules are now considered to be stable and ready for production use. Removed modules. The Qt 3D module has been removed. However, KDAB will continue to maintain it, example with respect to critical bugs and security vulnerabilities, and offer assistance to customers. New features in Qt Core. A new Qt Chrono Timer class, which can be used for more precise timing. More support for std chrono, a C++ standard library for working with time. Additionally, the introduction of new methods for qstring, qbyte array, and qlist. These new methods provide additional functionality for working with these data types. Qt QML module. Here we have new features added to the QML language server, such as semantic highlighting, JavaScript language support, and QML file renaming, to name a few. Qt Quick module. Multi-view rendering support for XR applications built with Qt Quick 3D has been added via the use of Qt Quick Render Target from Vulkan Image. So, quite a bit, but not everything. You can follow the description below to see the full list. Meeting C++ is back with a hybrid event in Berlin and online from the 14th to the 16th of November. KDAB will have a booth there, so come around and meet our colleagues if you attend. The author of the tools Hotspot and HeapTrack will be there too, giving live demonstrations. The Embedded Software Engineering Congress, in short ESE, will take place in Sindelfingen, Germany, from the 2nd to the 5th of December. An event with a who's who in embedded software, with over 1,200 attendees and over 100 presentations, keynotes, and seminars. Two of KDAB's embedded software experts will be available for a chat at the exhibition. Finally, here are some upcoming KDAB training courses that you can still sign up for before the end of the year. Debugging and Profiling Qt, Intro to Rust, Embedded Rust, or a combo of both, Programming with Qt 3D. For more information, head over to training.kdab.com. Thank you for watching, and remember, leave any questions or feedback below the video. I'll see you in the next KDAB News Flash.